Yep.
It was only one way that could go. Only one way to go.
That has got to be one of the craziest things I've ever seen at a Smash tournament. Like, in the game. Like, wow.
Like, creating your own taunt. Putting it on display for everyone to see.
That was wild.
And then hurting your opponent.
That was wild.
Yeah, that was wild.
That's rough, man.
That's something that you'll only get on locals.
Yeah.
Only get that at locals.
All right, so we got Amir. We got Larry Lur. If you've watched a lot of Smash 4 or even just like early Ultimate before we went into the Wi-Fi era, Amir has been a regular for the tournament scene.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, and he's been playing a lot. He played a lot of Miis, but ooh, man, I think that's the stock. Yeah, with the laser, that is not going to be able to get it back. And the forward air is so good against Min Min.
Yeah, I'm actually really surprised that we're seeing Aimer bring out Min Min, especially after Larry Lur's performance last week against Min Main, where he was down two games, switched to the bird, and then reverse 3-0'd.
Yeah, I mean, we might see Amir bring out like either Gunner or Brawler. That was Amir's mains before Min Min, but he really wanted Min Min in the game, like not just because Min Min's actually good, right? Like
right
in the beginning when everyone was like, I don't know about this character.
Yeah, Amir already hyped.
Yeah, he just likes arms, so he's probably going to stick it through, at least probably like first pick everything. We'll see how bad this game goes, but we might see a switch.
If I was a gambling man, I would expect maybe Gunner. I'm going to say Gunner.
Yeah, even Gunner, I think Brawler does well against any of those spaces. But yeah, right now, these the runoff fairs, the lasers, even the illusion there as a threat, Larry has so many options on the offstage assault here that just threatens Amir. And like Min Min's recovery, you just need to realistically just hit her with one of the moves, right?
Yeah, yeah. And I think like a lot of people get intimidated by her ability to really challenge Edgar's while also being able to recover low and snap to the ledge very quickly. But as you can see, Larry Lur, no fear. He knows exactly what he needs to do. He's continuously approaching his opponent. And Aimer definitely getting rushed down.
I don't know if a Mega Mawat Nair will do it here. Maybe now, maybe not at ground level. It's rough. Larry's doing a great job of avoiding the Mega Watt. This fair might not, this probably won't do it. Oh, wow,
peck.
It does.
Drill Peck's real strong, man.
I mean, with the rage there, it was pretty close. But I guess Larry also, like, you know, the forward air dragging closer to the blast zone.
Yeah.
So, yeah, really good stuff on Larry. Just the offstage fares, whether they be low, whether they be high fares, low fares, like, they're just going to, it's going to be a ton of, like, value, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just that move alone for the matchup offstage. And, yeah, here's the switch to Brawler.
Brawler?
I think Brawler does better against Spaceys.
Why Brawler and not Gunner?
Well, Falco has a frame one reflector.
Okay.
That,
I mean, yeah, you're right.
It's pretty good.
Uh-huh.
Pretty good. I mean, we might see the Gunner. We might see it.
I only suspected the Gunner to come out because I think out of the three Miis, Gunner is the one that Aimer is most comfortable with.
Yeah, I think that's fair.
Like, in terms of times played, brackets played, I feel like Gunner outshines the other two a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. We'll see what the Gunner can do. Falco can definitely sit back and not really deal with the shenanigans. So,
but can Larry Lur sit back and not deal with the shenanigans?
Larry will camp you very hard, actually. We have the charge shot, so there could be like some mix. And Amir's definitely got to really respect the illusion. The illusion did get buffed during quarantine, so during the Wi-Fi era. We do have we see the forward air being used for mobility here.
Taking his time, charging up the charge shot, but down tilt into forward air. The drill peck is such a good tool for spacing out your opponent and just challenging off stage.
Oh, that should be it. Yeah, that was such a smooth transition from Larry. The fact that the double jump actually looked like it was going to grab ledge there, but Larry barely got on stage and just smooth like butter. He just got on the stage, went right into an up tilt backer right at the edge like that. Even if you try to DI in, Larry's going to come out with the jump and then just double jump into you with the back air. Very clean by Larry and an entire stock lead off that setup.
Mm-hmm. Just fishing with Nairs. Oh, landing a forward air. But drill tech the forward air. And these multi-hits really doing a lot of work for Larry as he's able to control the space with a lot of aggression and then pretty much drag his opponent wherever he'd like all over the stage.
Yeah, Gunner doesn't have the craziest boxing options. Like, you have Nair, which is, like, kind of a budget Cloud Nair. You need some time to start up, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, Larry, essentially, I don't even feel like Larry's staying back. Larry's just rushing Amir down, and Amir
honestly
can't really do anything.
This is kind of what I was expecting from Larry. Even though we see the Gunner, yeah, Falco does have frame one reflector. He could sit back and, like, really force Amir to think outside the box and then kind of, like, using his projectiles, but... This is Larry Lurin. This is Falco. He's going to... Whoa, nice shot.
Larry not utilizing the reflector there.
He's going to run in. He's going to throw out these up tilts. He's going to set up the combo video, the cutscene.
Well, Larry's still using reflector as a mid-range. Like, he'll use it as a combo ender or even, like, in certain mid-range scenarios when Amir, like, has double jump and is coming back to stage. Just kind of throw the reflector out. It's a hitbox. It also can reflect if he tries to go for anything, right? So you're almost just, like, discouraging the fact. And the fact that you fling the reflector too, it's not like you're just going for reflector, which is why Falco's reflector is the best of all the spacey reflectors when just going against projectile characters, because you're also throwing out that hurt box threat, right? Mm-hmm. It's like a sword reflector almost.
True, very true, very true. But here you go. Aimer able to weave his way back on the stage. And now, oh, looking for a roll read.
Okay, joint. Moving to ledge here, Amir. Up smash not fully connecting, but the up air pickup, beautiful DI coming out from Larry, barely surviving there. Amir still wants to close out the second stock, the up smash. I like the platform kind of protecting Amir there, trying to go for the up air, but Larry not falling for it.
Yeah, of course, Larry playing Falco is going to have access to a very high double jump, which really just eliminated any sort of pressure that Aimer was trying to push from that up throw.
Oh, the down tilt was just a tad bit too early there from Amir. Could have been the stock. The ledge drop back air gets a forward tilt, miss input error, but Amir able to clean it up and still just come off of the platform with the back air, close out the stock. But a lot of work to be done here.
Can we talk about the pressure that Larry was just inputting by standing next to Aimer while he was in shield? Larry had invulnerability. He was just like, okay, normally if someone would push a button right about now, he just threw up. Use the up tilt. If it connected, that definitely would have been GG. But look at Aimer go, it's racking up the damage.
Beautiful DI on the down air there if Amir didn't DI that, but that should be at 166%. Yes, it is. Catching either ledge drop or ledge drop double jump, some kind of, you know, the fair is such a good lingering option for Falco multi-hits. It can, like, kind of lose out on trades if they come out with a strong ledge drop double jump option, but very, very good, like, lingering aerial to kind of throw out for Falco on the ledge trap.